All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Peter Paul Van Hoeken, the CEO of FrontFundr. And Peter Paul, great to see you again. How are you?
Thanks, Steve. I'm great. And thanks for having me today.
Yeah, just remind everyone a little bit about FrontFundr.
Sure. So FrontFundr is Canada's leading equity crowdfunding platform, operating from coast to coast. And what FrontFundr does is basically connecting companies, typically startups, early stage companies, with the wider investor community. Emphasis on wider, really meeting any investor. So whether you're a smaller retail investor or you're a larger angel investor, everybody basically can invest through FrontFundr.
Yeah, maybe you could sort of talk us through sort of the private versus public markets and how sort of crowdfunding fits into that.
Sure. Yeah, there's always, of course, a lot of attention going to the public markets. That's kind of where all the action is, and certainly now with the exchanges doing very well. But what people don't, not many people realize, is that the private markets is actually twice as much capital is raised in the private markets compared to the public markets. And of course, that also includes public companies raising in the private markets, but it's a really, the private markets is really growing fast. And if you look at the returns in the private markets based on several reports, they're around 3 to 4% higher compared to the public market. So it's a really attractive asset class for the wider investor community to participate in.
Yeah. And let's talk about this sort of unlocking a large amount of capital. As you mentioned, there is quite a bit in the private markets. And for some people, they like the opportunity to get into a company early, yet trying to sort of pay that retail price when you're doing it in the public markets.
Yeah, totally. So indeed, you're absolutely right, Steve. Traditionally, the retail investors, they only get access to invest in a company when it's growing and when it goes public, because then it's trading and then everybody can participate. So traditionally, the smaller the retail investors have been locked out from investing in these companies from the very beginning. And that's basically what we've changed with FrontFundr is, well, why don't we enable those investors to come in those companies, invest in those companies from the very beginning?
Yeah, I'm interested to know about crowdfunding and where it's gone. If this was 10 years ago, you know, people would say, oh, there's an interesting product or something like that, but not really a company to invest in as far as crowdfunding is concerned. But it seems like that's really starting to change and that it's becoming more mainstream for companies to find financing that way.
Yeah, totally. So crowdfunding sort of started on the started with the donations and rewards based crowdfunding. And what we now see was really taken off across the globe is financial crowdfunding. So investment crowdfunding or equity crowdfunding, meaning that you're truly, as an investor, invest in these companies and you share in the potential upside and the risk as well. But that's really participating, become a co-owner in these companies. And in Canada, we now see it really starting to grow. I would say the market is still in its early days, in its infancy, but the regulators have made moves and made it more attractive to raise capital through investment crowdfunding. And if we see where it's going in a geography like the UK, for example, where it started about 5 years earlier than in Canada, so started around 2010 in the UK, around 40% of startups are raising capital through investment crowdfunding. So it already went mainstream in the UK, and it's poised to go mainstream in Canada as well.
Yeah, and in fact, FrontFundr itself is doing it also, because you're in a capital raise right now, and why not do it the way that you're telling everyone else to do it?
Totally, yeah. And you know, Steve, we like to you know, drink our own whiskey, use our own platform to raise capital. And we've done it already 3 times. And we are indeed currently doing a fourth round through our platform. We're targeting $1.5 million. We're already well on our way. We're just past the 1.4. So we're really heading towards closing of this round. And yeah, we're basically inviting anyone really to participate and become a co-owner in FrontFundr itself.
Yeah, Peter Paul, just quickly, if someone's interested in your platform or getting a little bit more about crowdfunding as a financial source, what's the best way for people to get more information?
Sure, the easiest is to go to our website, so frontfundr.com. All the information is there, our own listing, but also a number of other companies. And indeed, you can also learn more about how does investment crowdfunding work. And you can, of course, participate and complete an investment through our online platform.
There you go. Peter Paul, thank you so much. Great to catch up with you again.
Thank you.
All right, there's Peter Paul Van Hoeken, the CEO of FrontFundr.